It'd probably help if I clicked on the chat bar first.
Indeed. Okay, so we're all ready.
Is Gretchen not joining us today?
He has some stuff going on.
So anyway. Who will blindly murder people for no reason?
I'm sure Nero will fill that role.
He's going to save Biscuit.
Biscuit is more than capable of saving Biscuit.
This is true. He's a strong, independent lizard woman.
Who don't need no man.
Don't need no man.
That's right. So last time you guys were playing, you were dealing with Lord Pidgey, whom that has become his name now. And you made a deal to go take care of the pirates in exchange for basically some political freedom from your actions here in the town you just razed to the ground.
I mean, not the whole town. Just the bulk of it.
About like an eighth of the entire city is burnt at this point.
See, there's still plenty left we could burn.
You guys fought the pirates, destroyed the ships, and Biscuit was getting hauled off towards the ocean, which the pirates noticed that their ships were gone. And poor codename Ludin and Nero, your friend, well, at least companion, traveling companion at the very least, is out cold from the battle.
Yeah, he is.
Let me find the marching order.
I know me and Biscuit were like at the top.
Yep, I got him right here. So Biscuit, you are currently restrained on one lizard person on each arm. It is your turn.
I'm going to try to break free.
Okay.
Wonderful.
Yes.
I love that.
Strength saving throw. Okay. Okay, so you beat both of them.
Wow.
You are free from their grasp.
I'm not a happy lizard.
They were not ready for that strong, independent lizard.
Biscuit taps into his inner butterfly.
I'm going to run back towards the group.
Okay. So you try to disengage and run towards the group?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Having seen you do this, they actually don't even attack you as you begin to run away, and you make it back to the group.
Creepers.
See, if it was any of the other people in this party, he would have chosen to attack us.
Sure. It's because we're not lizard people.
Yeah.
Yep.
That and Justin's a spiteful bitch.
No,
I know. He blew the front door of my house off.
There's legitimate reasons for these characters why they didn't attack Biscuit. Yeah. They haven't attacked Biscuit this entire encounter.
Yeah, they clearly want Biscuit.
They want that dragon dick.
Death by Oreo.
You make it back to the party. It's still your turn.
Still my turn?
Yeah, you haven't done anything other than run. Yeah. And break free. You have a bonus action, basically.
Oh, I just wanted to be free.
Oh, okay. Well, all right. It is now Illithor's turn.
Sweet. All right. What's around me?
Where are you on the map? Okay, at the moment, it is the executioner who is still dead on top of the stadium. You have one captain who is alive. And two pirates above you. You have a dirt hill going upwards towards the party, and you have just a bunch of random little knickknacks from the execution, like torches and rope, all over the ground.
All right. So basically just like a bunch of like small objects.
Yeah, you're basically in a field with a bunch of small objects around you.
That's what I figured.
You are standing in green grass. It has been very well kept, aside from the fires as of late.
Well, at least that's one thing they did right in this city that we're also slowly destroying.
Yeah.
Right. Well, then just for amusement's sake, then, just got to make sure I see how this works. I'm going to cast Animate Objects on pretty much those small items that are nearby.
Okay.
Get myself a little army to go against the pirates.
The two are that are left and the one captain.
Got to try it out before we get into a bigger fight.
Fair enough. Let me read it real quick.
I can choose up to 10 non-magical objects. Let's see. Yeah, small objects, but just count as one. And if it's... Or tiny. I don't know what size you would consider all of those.
I would consider the rope as medium, the torches as small, and there's like little knickknacks on the ground if you wanted to pick up like forks and knives and stuff too. Those would be tiny.
How many torches would you say?
Let's roll for it. Roll a d6.
D6? All right.
There are 5 torches.
All right. So I guess we'll do 5 torches.
Okay.
We'll do the rope, which will count as 2, so that'll be 7.
Yep.
And then just 3 tiny things, so I guess forks and knives.
Let's see. You get 3 knives.
Sweet.
Okay, so you do that. You basically... summon the energy within yourself to put this blue aura around the items around you, and they begin to lift into the air at your command.
All right. And then I will just, as my bonus action then, kind of command them to go after the... we'll send them after the 2 pirates that were trying to haul Biscuit away.
Okay. I'm just going to make this here as all of them at the same time. Unless you want to specifically coordinate all of the attacks on different people at the same time.
Well, here, we'll send the rope after the pirate captain that's next to me. All the smaller items can go after the 2 pirates.
Okay.
Yeah. Random junk army.
They actually do have stats for their attack. I'm sure you're looking at it now.
Yep.
Okay. It's so funny that their AC is 18 for a tiny object.
It makes up for the fact that it has no health. All right. Now, would that be next turn that they attack, I believe? Yep, during its next turn.
Yep.
Alright. No? I still have stuff to do. No, that actually is my turn.
Okay. It's not the captain's turn. It is the pirate's turn. They see these objects flying towards them, the 2 pirates that are on the beach side, and they start trying to attack it. Just random pieces. This is the first pirate. Misses. She's just swinging around, just kind of missing everything with her daggers. And the second one tries to attack and also misses. They're just frantically trying to hit these knives and little torches and just are failing at doing so. It's actually kind of comical how much they're failing at hitting these items.
It's one of the reasons why I took the spell.
At that point, it comes to Sebastian's turn.
Okay. I'm going to... Am I behind or in front of the captain?
You are behind.
Okay.
Because he's facing Illithor. Or she is facing Illithor.
I don't like that he keeps rolling percentiles.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to try to go into stealth.
Do that at a disadvantage because you're in combat with them at the moment.
Oh. Okay.
Fuck.
Disadvantage strikes again.
Alright, never mind.
She almost failed it.
Well, she does have a random piece of rope coming after her.
Yeah.
Okay.
You would already gain the bonuses from stealth because Illithor's next to her anyway.
Yep.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
To bite her in the butt.
If you have an ally within 5 feet of the enemy you're targeting, you gain stealth attack bonuses. Even if you're in middle of daylight and everyone sees you. Doesn't matter.
Yep. That's why rogues are so deadly. Unless they're spells in the open.
Well, I'm a monk, not a rogue. Does it still apply?
Actually, shit. Well, no, that wouldn't work for monk. I was thinking of rogue.
Yeah.
But you do gain the bonus of flanking, so you still gain the same bonus because you're directly behind her.
Okay.
But for a different reason.
I'm going to go ahead and attack her twice for the first one.
Okay. You hit.
Okay. Roll the damage for that.
Wow, that's a good hit.
Alright, second attack.
Second one misses.
Alright, I'm going to use a key point to attack again.
Okay. That one hits.
Thank God. Oh, wait. Am I still getting the... Am I getting sneak damage to the behind her or nah?
That's advantage, so yeah, you would...
Alright, so I'm just adding 3 to my attack then.
That's fine.
Alright, and then add 3 to the other 16, so it'd be 19 and 16 damage.
Well. Alright. Math.
What?
Oh, I'm just mathing, right? Just making sure I'm doing it good. Okay, so you run up behind the captain. She has... Not really entranced, but she's confused as to this rope. Her rope, mind you, from her ship, specifically her ship, that has now turned the tables and is trying to attack her. At that moment, Sebastian runs up and bites her square in the butt. The good, solid chunk of the meat just kind of rips off with him.
Nice.
Damn. Wow.
These ropes ain't loyal.
I wonder if Sebastian is one of those Navy SEAL German Shepherds that has the titanium teeth.
Hey, you don't know.
Actually, he might know because he got bit by
him. Yeah, how's that dick feel?
Less.
Less.
I wouldn't say he would know better than anybody, really.
Those wounds are still healing.
So as you do that, you actually bite her, and you rip the flesh off, and her blood just starts gushing out. At that point, Illithor sees her facial expression. She goes blank. She turns pale despite her reptilian skin, and she passes out on the ground.
Oh, wow.
Sweet. Key word, though, passes out.
All right, so that's your turn. Who is next? It would be Gretchen. Okay, so at this time, let me grab it. 1 second. My paper. Everybody
Gretchen's
roll.
Got harder and innocent.
Now, everybody roll perception checks.
Uh oh. Shit's about to go down.
What's with these rolls, man? Can I get advantage? Because I'm a dog.
Sure.
Seems none of us are very perceptive today.
Damn, look at you with your 21.
Would my passive play into effect?
Yes. So Illithor and Sebastian both hear this sound coming from above them, and it's like something heavy is falling through the sky, at which point they look up, and they literally see the Black Knight fall down and land directly onto Gretchen. At that time, the hand of Gretchen flies out with a middle finger flying directly over top of Solaire, and the rest of his body parts go exploding all over the entire battlefield.
What?
So
I guess this means Matt is making a new character.
Gretchen!
His fourth one.
Gretchen?
Black Knight dead? Black Knight is dead. Or is he?
Is that the one we pushed over the fucking bridge?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, at a height like that, I would think he's dead.
We did not think that through at the time.
Who would have guessed it was directly over Waterdeep?
We're going to, like, overthink pushing somebody off an edge now.
Wait, innocent people by pushing them off the edge and then having...
Don't push them off that cliff. We might end up below it one day.
So as the clanking of the armor settles and Gretchen's blood starts oozing out from underneath the Black Knight, you notice that the sky is a little darker than it used to be.
I don't notice shit because I'm unconscious.
Correct.
Your dreams are a little darker than they used to be.
That's a lot, considering my dreams are already pretty dark.
So, John, roll a constitution saving throw, or the death save throw, basically, the d20 by itself. So that's a fail.
That's good. I looked up at first and saw that one. I was like, ooh, and then I realized that was your roll from back then.
John, how many of you failed so far?
Two.
Okay.
Oh.
Nobody knows that, though. But,
yeah.
Okay. All right, so after that, it comes to
Franz. Is that
going to
be the shortest lived character ever?
Franz, how many death fails do you have right now?
Zero, because I was revived and knocked the fuck out by Gretchen again.
Okay.
That is, because he was really close.
I got him.
Oh.
Oh.
Wow.
Oh.
my god.
Did that really just happen?
So.
Well, I mean, it's no big secret. I roll more ones than anyone else.
Yeah, but you also always live.
That's the end of an era.
I never got to use this character.
Are we about to lose like three party members in one night?
So at this point, after the blood starts settling, Ludin tries to sit up for a moment and just falls back down. Nero tries to get up, and in that moment, his eyes just shut, and he falls limp. Biscuit is standing directly over Nero as he falls limp. And it is the top of the round now. It's Biscuit's turn.
Biscuit's going to have
This is not how I wanted to start today.
Shit.
Oh my gosh.
doesn't even know what to do.
It won't. For one, Biscuit's friend is just shattered into a million pieces.
This is how I would die. I literally got to do nothing with my Dark Knight.
Damn, that's so sad.
Biscuit seen the Dark Knight and, Gretchen's death.
Biscuit does what? He just sees this and doesn't know how to react?
I was going to say, has he seen it?
Yes, he just witnessed this right in front of him.
So, I'm going to go... He's going to go over to the Black Knight and just start kicking him viciously.
Is Biscuit wearing shoes?
Not unless they were part of the sexy leather outfit.
They would have been because Freya would have been wearing heels. So you're wearing heels.
Biscuit's wearing heels.
This just gets better and better.
So Biscuit's like curb stomping this Black Knight with his heels, right?
David, are you recording this?
I am.
Okay. He's trying to swear, but he doesn't know any swear words.
Do a performance check. Do a performance check.
I have plus 5 on performance. Holy crap.
Means you're good at it. Oh.
No.
Do it at advantage because you just saw the death of your companion, one of your close friends. Okay.
It's a little better.
So at this point, the rest of the party sees Biscuit almost in tears, just screaming out, almost in a Tourette's fashion, just like, butterflies, pancakes, good things, as he's just like kicking the crap out of this dead Black Knight that's been over top of Gretchen's body, now next to the dead, lifeless body of Nero Bjorn.
Dark turn.
All right. You're gonna need your turn. Yeah. Ilthor.
Okay. First, should I roll initiative for my objects?
Yes.
Because from what I see, it doesn't take my.
But lump turn. Them into two groups, just the big group and small group.
All right. Let's see. Should I just do a straight up, Well, no, because they do technically have dex.
They don't have dex. Oh, they do.
Yeah.
Shit. Then yes, use their dex for the initiative.
Alright.
Whatever modifier that would be.
So we'll do Tiny first. Ooh. Tiny is not feeling it.
So that is a 1.
And we'll do the small.
An 8. Okay.
And then the medium.
15.
Okay, at least the rope's somewhat trying to do something. All right. Well, now that that's out of the way, crap. I guess I will. I guess I'll just do one more fireball just to try to get this over with.
Okay.
Just kind of far enough back behind the two pirates so that it only hits them.
They failed the check.
All right. What
a shitty time for a cleric to die.
Yeah.
He even revived me before he knocked me the fuck back out again, and I died anyway.
I will use a sorcery point just to strengthen that, just in case. So I'll re-roll those ones and twos. So 27 minus 5, so 22 plus 7. So 29 fire damage.
29. Okay. 29. Okay. So you go to launch fireball one more time. Your objects are incinerated in this action.
Yeah, I figured.
However, the pirates are on fire at this point, and they have taken massive damage. They're running around just trying to pat themselves down. And the field that you had launched this fireball in is now scorched. Yet another version of...
I told you, there's still more of the city. Down. And I guess as they're running around, like, trying to put the flames out, I'll just kind of motion to them to just give up.
Okay, so roll a persuasion check.
That's something I haven't done in a while.
Tyler, you just got called.
Yeah, my dog's going insane.
All right. Wow.
Both of them literally run towards the ships, the broken ships, and they just jump in the water and start swimming away.
You know, so hopefully they'll get a lifeboat.
Maybe.
And then I will use my movement to start going towards the my unconscious companions to kind of see how they're doing. Since at the moment I don't know that Nero's dead.
Okay, so you walk up, and basically between both of them, you see that Luden is barely hanging on to his, or codename Luden, is barely hanging on to his life, and Nero does not seem to be breathing.
I wouldn't be able to give Luden a healing potion, would I?
Why not?
Well, because I didn't know if, seeing as I casted a fireball.
Oh, no. Yeah, then you wouldn't be able to.
Did you unless we're section?
Unless we're no longer considered in battle.
You don't know that.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Because, yeah, I would have to actually force feed you, so it'd kind of be more than a bonus action.
You can just kind of pour it over his mouth if you can hope you're lucky and roll percentages.
Actually, I will just do a healing word as a bonus action.
Okay.
I forgot I had that since.
There you go. And that will stabilize him if you succeed.
Wait, I thought when you roll a 1 and you do a death save, you're dead.
Yeah, you are. He's talking about Luden.
Oh.
Yeah, I have no ability to bring anybody back from the dead.
Are you all out of wishes?
Well, actually, I do technically still have a wish. But trying to bring somebody back from the dead with a wish is one really,
Yeah.
Alright, so you gain...
Don't know till you try.
6 hit points.
Alright. You just, jot that down.
You're still unconscious, but you're alive.
Whew. Do I get rid of my death save fails?
Yeah, because you're stabilized now. That resets.
And then I'll just kind of lean down to check on Nero and just kind of, you know, ask Biscuit and Sebastian how they're doing. And that'll be my turn.
Okay. So you guys see your companion walk over, stabilize this foreign man who has hated you in combat, and talk to amongst the rest of you.
Who we still don't know his name.
Correct. So at that point, it's actually your rope's turn. The rope wraps around the captain's neck and starts lifting into the air like a noose. It just continues to lift.
Nice.
At least something's getting practice.
So at this point, it just wrapped around and began to lift it just a couple inches. It didn't get too far yet, just because it doesn't have enough strength per turn.
Yeah.
Let's see, who's next? Well, he is... gone. Sebastian.
Good talk.
He's AFK at the moment.
Ah. We'll come back to him. He has held his action.
He's being a good boy.
He's being a good boy. Alright, so it is now... John, it's your go.
What do I do?
You have to give me a constitution saving throw to see if you wake up. Is that with your modifier?
No, I don't know my modifier.
Do you not? What's your constitution
it's
score?
It's 8 plus 3.
Okay, so yeah, you're still asleep. Okay, so that's the end of your turn. Fuck. Front's dead too. Okay, so Biscuit.
Yes.
It's your go.
We're just all
Biscuit is going to march back towards the pirates.
5, 10. Like how far? Like just all the way?
All the way. I can get 30 feet.
Uh oh. Y'all done pissed Biscuit off.
Okay.
Biscuit lost their favorite person.
I'm just picturing the Keanu Reeves moment when his dog gets killed. Only this time it's a trusted companion, and now he's going over edge.
Okay. I am going to cast Wall of Water directly in front of the pirate ships there.
Okay.
And
so, like, behind them, like, in the water?
It's, like, between us. But this is a question for you. If so, like, I do here? That, can I...
Can you what?
Can you what?
Can I move it? Can I choose to push it forward?
Well, I mean, they're already in the water.
Right. But they'd have a 10-foot-high wall of water coming at them.
She wants to make, like, a tidal wave.
Yeah.
Oh, I see what you're saying. Hold on, just let me...
I don't know, because there's actually a spell for creating tsunamis.
Is there really?
What's the spell? Is it water wall, not wall of water?
Wall of water...
Oh, that's right. You have the weird spell that I don't have on my in my book. Just for the sake of role playing, we will allow it.
Yeah, because screw those pirates.
So you're pushing it. Is it already in the water and it's coming towards them, like towards yourself? Okay.
Coming away from me, but towards them. So, away from shore.
And yeah, tsunami is an 8th level spell. Awesome. But that...
How big is Wall of Water, like, lengthwise?
It's 10 feet high, 30 feet long.
Okay, so 10, 20, 30. Let me make this smaller. Okay. So here is this tidal wave coming towards the shore where you are standing.
Nah.
Huh?
Cast it, like, going this direction. Like, away from shore. Can't clear that now.
They haven't gotten too far. They're, like, here. So if you're trying to create a tsunami from, like, the beach water? I don't understand.
Could she just rise it up from underneath them and just, like, launch them up into the air?
That'd work too, actually.
Yes.
Because that should be fun to watch.
Okay. I like so your
I'm
thinking.
I'm just going to get rid of that. That was confusing. Anyway... So as you go to cast this, you guys see Biscuit literally just stomping. Not even running or walking. He's stomping towards this beach. He puts his hands up and summons this torrential water from the depths of the water that the pirates are under. And they actually start flying into the air at this point. They are about 60 feet into the air. As they begin falling back down towards the ground. Not even the ocean, towards the ground. And both of them, as they hit the ground, take... Let's see... 12 damage each. And as that happens, you see them... both reaching out towards Biscuit, just kind of trying to crawl towards you, basically, as they fall to the ground, collapsing.
Like when Anakin lost his legs, and he's going, "I hate you!"
Exactly. The rage of Biscuit has been seen.
Done, ticked him off.
Okay, so is that the end of your turn? You guys are now out of combat, aside from the captain, who I need to roll to see if she wakes up. She does not wake up. You said what?
That's the end of my turn.
Okay, David just left, so you guys are out of combat. What would you like to do?
Try to wake up.
Okay.
Wish I wasn't dead.
One more constitution saving throw, John. There you go. You are awake.
Must be nice.
These old bones just ain't what they used to be. Seems like the kid bit off more than he could chew.
Mm.
What a shame.
Rubbing salt in the wound.
Forward to that 25 gold pieces. I'm going to walk over to the rest of the group and see what's going on.
Okay. You walk over and you see Nero on the ground, not breathing. You see Gretchen's hand frozen in the position of a middle finger resting on Nero's chest. And everyone is dead except for you guys and the captain, who is asleep with a noose around her neck as it's slowly lifting into the air.
I want to look to Illithor and ask him if he wants to interrogate the captain or let them die.
I don't believe I've gotten your name.
You can call me Luden.
Illithor.
Just an old sailor.
Not an old sailor.
Well met, Kim.
I suppose we should, just in case there's more out there.
Alright, well, you take care of that, and I'll go give these two a proper burial.
Alright, I'll kind of just send a command to the rope to stop. Just to kind of like hold her in place, not to lift her any further.
Okay. The rope
To take Solaire and Gretchen in. Hold on, can I see if there's like any kind of cart nearby?
You can do an investigation check.
Investigation.
You do actually find one cart. It's not really the best quality, but you do find a cart.
How convenient.
I'm going to pull their bodies onto the cart and start making my way to the City of the Dead.
Okay.
And I relay the message to the rest of the party that that's where I'm headed.
As you go to... Well, you put Nero on the cart, no problem. However, you're finding great difficulty in retrieving Gretchen's body, since the Black Knight is literally on top of him.
Alright, I want to try to use my strength to roll the Black Knight over.
Okay. Okay, so you start lifting, and using your strength, you get it to budge an inch before it falls back down to the ground.
I want to clap my hands and say, well, that's the best I could do.
Oh, shit.
And then I'm going to go ahead and escort this. Okay. All right, let's try together now. So do we do that at advantage?
Sebastian, come over and help.
He's not here, but yes, Sebastian helps too. I don't know what his strength is, so I'm going to assume a plus 4. Fuck.
Come on.
Okay, so using all of your powers to lift this Black Knight, you begin to do so. And Sebastian's even helping a little bit too. As he starts to strain, he takes the biggest shit all over the ground.
Oh my god.
The strain just was too much for his small doggy body, and he just poops.
Horrible.
Which distracts both of you, and you drop him again.
Fuck's sake. Third time's a charm.
I guess I'll join in. I'm not much help, but...
Okay, so cumulative strength check of everybody here.
Well, if I was alive, I could do it.
Yep. Who's missing?
Dead don't talk.
Biscuit.
I rolled mine already.
No, you gotta do it again. You weren't listening.
Yeah, y'all failed, so we gotta try it again.
Okay.
Ooh.
So using the combined powers of four people, you guys flip the Black Knight over entirely.
Lifting things. There's always that moment in D&D where the party gets stumped by one object.
You guys all take four damage from just the pure strain of lifting something so heavy.
Let's not do that again. It's a good thing I was at full health.
Alright, so we rolled him over. And I'll try to pick up Gretchen's body again.
Okay.
And put him on the cart.
Strength check. Okay, so you do that fairly easily. You lift him up, kind of fireman's carry, and you drop him on the cart. I don't know how you drop him on the cart. That's up to you.
Gently.
Gently, okay.
These are their companions. I'm not going to disrespect them.
Okay.
And I'm going to hurl their bodies to the city of the dead and get ready for a burial.
Okay, so Luden does that. What do the rest of you do, Biscuit and Illithor?
Rot.
I'll try to, like, just kind of smack the captain across the cheek a few times, see if she'll wake up.
She does wake up from this. She is restrained, but she is awake.
Who are you?
She literally just looks over at you and hisses.
Yes, yes, I imagine we're not your favorite people at the moment. But the rest of your people are gone. Your ships are gone. Might as well cooperate.
Do a persuasion check.
So many things I don't normally have to do. And everybody's rolling so low tonight.
She looks over at you, and you can see this glare in her eyes. And then she looks over at Biscuit, and it's almost this loving affection kind of motherly look she gives him. And then looks back at you, and it's just pure rage. You hiss at her. Do an intimidation check, Biscuit.
Those things just don't sound like they go hand in hand.
Oh, wow. Dear God.
Wow.
Wow. So the female dragonborn captain goes over to look at Biscuit, looks back at Illithor angrily, and then sees Biscuit hissing at her. She whimpers at this point and just puts her head down, sulking, and says, "What do you want to know?"
Are there more of you out there?
No. This was the rest of our clan. If they've all died, as you say, then I am all that remains.
Why attack the city?
It was a task given to us by this powerful being.
What being?
I don't know his name.
Well, describe him to me.
He's got these hooves, and he's very fat looking, and he had this presence about him with this wand he was carrying around.
But he gave no name.
No name. He had great power. I could feel it off of him, and I felt as if I said no, he would kill every one of my clans. So we did as he asked and tried to raid the city at its weakest time.
And when did you run into this being?
It was a couple months back, and he told us to wait until the time was right.
Can I just do an insight check just to verify?
Sure.
Might as well get all these things I don't have to do very often.
So you basically use your wizard abilities and you look into her soul, straight through her eyes, the windows of her soul. I just saw your post, Franz. And you sense that she is genuinely afraid, and you also feel her looking back into you a little bit as you're doing this. It's kind of a mutual soul glazing, if you will. That was for you, Brianna.
So what's next?
What's next is I'm the last of my kind of the pirate kin, and I have no bargaining chip other than a large amount of gold I could potentially offer you for my release.
And what becomes of you?
I'll live in solitude, of course, and make a living doing what I do best.
Not afraid that this being that sent you here might come for you?
Oh, I'm sure he will. But it'd be better to die by him 10 years from now than by your hands now, you filthy human or whatever you are. Biscuit, oh Biscuit, you are the ordained one. You are a savior for our people. There's literally a statue of you in my hometown.
What?
You failed to mention this.
We don't talk to your kind. She looks over at Biscuit just adoringly. Please come back with me. Let me take you to the town.
Can I do another insight check?
All right. And what did you say, Biscuit?
Only if my friends can come.
So at this point, Ilthor knows, as he's analyzing this lady, that this is an outright lie. That you don't know why she has lied about this, or even what part was lied about, but there is a definitive lie about her words about the statue of Biscuit and Biscuit being the ordained one.
Please don't lie to us. Biscuit's too kind of an individual for... Tell us, what really did you want with him?
Do a persuasion check.
Oh. Why does that always have to happen?
She looks over at you and just scoffs and looks back at Biscuit and says to Biscuit, please, we have lots of butterflies there. We hear that's what you enjoy.
I want to tell my rope to tighten up a little bit.
All right. So you do that. It tightens up around her neck. As she begins to describe the butterflies to Biscuit, there's all colors, little purples and pinks and light blues and browns, of all sizes as well. Biscuit is typing.
Dun, dun, dun.
John, are you here? Good talk.
Guess not.
Okay, do a strength check.
I was like, did he really go to the City of the Dead?
Little do you know, Luden is a necromancer, and he took your companions for his own army.
He technically could be. We have not figured out anything about him.
All right, I'm back.
Welcome. People have died. Luden is carrying dead bodies, and Ilthor is interrogating this captain.
Okay, who died besides Franz?
Gretchen.
That's right.
Yeah.
And then the rest of the pirates.
Yeah, all the pirates except for this captain.
What are the guards doing?
What guards?
The ones above us.
These ones up here, they're dead. I just didn't...
Okay. I just looked up and noticed them. I was like, I didn't know there was anybody else left alive.
No, you made sure of that.
Well, I said where it wouldn't hit anybody.
I'm just saying in general for Waterdeep. Yeah. When in doubt, blame Ilthor for countless civilian deaths.
Yeah, I'll come to judgment with it one day.
Mm.
That does suck, because now that Nero and Gretchen are both dead. I am the most... Ah, crap.
Okay. So you guys are out of battle. Luden has reached the City of the Dead at this point.
So how's this?
I'm gonna follow Luden.
Okay.
I'll just look at Biscuit and ask, should we let her go, or should we bury her with the rest?
Damn.
As long as she doesn't try to touch me, I'm okay.
Do you hear that?
She nods her head in agreement, begrudgingly.
And I will do one more insight check. God! You, I hope we don't fight nothing strong.
As far as you can tell, she was genuine in her nod.
Yeah. Alright. I'll just kind of... I'll have the rope turn her slightly so she can look at all the flames.
Okay.
And just say, you know, I'll let you go. But don't think about trying anything.
She nods in agreement one more time.
And don't follow us.
She nods in agreement one more time.
Go live out the rest of your days. I get the feeling all of ours are going to be much shorter.
So what happens at this point?
I'll tell the rope to release her.
She has been released.
Which at this point, I think technically the rope would have gone back to just being rope.
Yeah.
Because I don't think the spell lasts that long.
I don't know. I didn't really look.
Yeah, it's just for a minute.
Oh, well, yeah. Okay, so...
We sped talked the entire conversation.
Yeah, it was a quick conversation. So she just walks back towards the ships at this point.
Which are burnt down.
Which are burnt down. Yeah, she walks back. You don't know what she's doing, but she's walking towards them.
Alright, I'll delay for a while longer just to kind of continue to watch her go. Okay. And then I guess we'll start heading towards City of the Dead.
Biscuit, what are you doing?
I am going to follow the bulk of the party.
Bulk of the party, okay. Okay, so at this point, Sebastian and Luden have been discussing... We are now caught up to that conversation.
Sure thing. Go ahead and dig your hole.
Justin?
Yeah.
I don't know if you want to roll a strength check or anything. I'm just going to dig a ditch big enough to fit their body, and then I'm going to cremate them.
Just do it at advantage. See how fast you do it.
You're going to dig them a grave and then cremate them? What?
It's going to be like a funeral pyre, but in the ground.
Oh, okay. I was so fucking confused.
He's only doing it as a dog would understand. Give him a break.
Good thing that was an advantage. Okay, so... Yeah. Was you join your master?
While he's digging, can I investigate Solaire's body?
Yeah, do your investigation as you had... Okay, so you find that... Or actually, no, you don't find any gold.
He didn't have any gold, no.
Yeah, you find no gold on his body.
Do I find anything worthwhile, at least?
You'd have to ask
There's
Camo.
My axe.
I was like, I'm sure he has something that's worth 25 gold.
Do you have something
There's
that's worth 25 gold?
There's my axe. There's my demon armor. There's my headband that raises your intelligence to 19. There's my prosthetic hands. Let's see, what else is there? Oh, and there's boots that if you click the heels, you can move forward 40 feet.
Can I take the headband?
I mean,
I don't give a shit. I'm dead.
He can't stop you.
Right, if you want to take him from man. Him.
It's just a matter of Sebastian stuff.
That's what he owes me.
He can take the headband.
I'd take the headband.
Okay.
Somebody must not be very smart.
So Sebastian... my intelligence fucking sucks, dude.
Sebastian goes to town on this hole. You just see him just start furiously digging for at least a good hour.
What's the headband called?
Headband of intelligence.
Do I catch up to the city by now if it took him like an hour?
So at this point, Ilithor, you were watching this captain, and you see her rummage through the bodies of the remaining pirates who were dead, and she actually started walking towards the castle area. If you wanted to, what did you want to do in regard to that as she began walking towards the city again? Or just ignore her or anything, because you don't know what she's doing. She could just be leaving town because she has no way to leave by water. You don't know.
Yeah. Do I recall seeing any kind of boats that weren't in the area we blew up?
Do a history check.
All right. Because I've been rolling so well tonight.
question. How long do you think we'll be playing tonight?
We can end whenever, really.
Okay, because I have other characters set up and ready to go.
Okay.
I just don't know if I'll be able to add them in this round.
It just depends on what they do, you know?
You want me to send you the specs and stuff?
You don't have to send me anything. You can just use them and tell me...
All right, I guess I'll just message you on Facebook and whatnot.
Yeah,
so
do that so I know who it is and I can make it work.
Unless you just want to wander around as Nero's ghost for the next couple hours.
How could this happen to
making faces behind us, behind our backs.
Man, can I look around for a shovel because I don't have one on my person?
Do an investigation check. Ilithor, what are you doing with this captain, if anything?
I was trying to see if I recalled seeing any boats that weren't in that section that we blew up. 22 was my history check.
You remembered seeing all of the boats that were currently there getting blown up by your fireballs.
Alright, I was afraid of that.
So her actions don't seem out of the normal at this point. Granted, she doesn't have a choice unless she wants to just swim home.
Yeah.
Are you ignoring her? Are you heading back? What are you doing?
I'll keep watching a little bit longer then.
Okay, so the party at this point, John, you do find a shovel.
All right, I'm going to go ahead and start digging a grave for Gretchen while the dog prepares one for them.
Okay, there are three dead bodies here, so keep that in mind.
Yes, we are repopulating the city of the dead. One companion at a time.
Okay. So, just do a general strength check, John. Okay, so you're doing it a little bit faster paced than what Sebastian is, but it's not easy work making these holes as big as they need to be for specifically Nero with the fused demon armor to his body. That makes it very difficult.
Remove curse or being killed allows you to remove it.
Okay, well, they don't know that. Okay, so you guys start digging, and
What's happening?
You guys are just digging holes. Biscuit's okay. Not doing anything.
Before we light him on fire, I want to see if there's anything I can salvage from his demon armor.
Okay.
I want to wear demon armor on a dog.
So you find... do an investigation check so I can see how much you find that is salvageable.
You find his socks.
Jesus. Ooh.
You find everything he... Oh.
Okay. Do a D100 check for yourself.
Wait, does that mean I failed it because you got a 27?
No, that was just, D100.
That's something I'm doing for something else. Okay, so Franz, what is the demon armor that you have? Can you read it aloud?
Yeah, let me pull up a sheet real quick. I'm fucking dead.
I didn't think we'd ever see this day.
Let's see.
I really thought we were all going to go through like 20 characters
demon
each.
Demon armor plus 1 AC allows you to be fluent in abyssal, clawed gauntlets, turn on magic into magic attacks, as well as allowing you to have unarmed attacks of 1d8 plus 1 bonus to attack and damage rolls. Cannot remove armor without remove curse spell. It doesn't say anything about it being dead, but I mean, I probably didn't think I would die, so I didn't write that in there, maybe.
I didn't think I would die.
So, fucking, you know, I'm dead, so if you incinerate my body, it's demon armor, it's not going to burn. So it'll just hollow out the armor, and then anybody can wear it after that.
All right, I found it.
Stop being all logical in your death.
So yeah, Tyler, if you were with your high roll that you
I also
got,
had the executioner scythe, but I think I gave that to the Lord. Not to think
you,
about
you
it.
Did give that to him. He has that. Tyler, you obtain basically enough pieces. Do a sleight of hand? No, survival check.
Okay. Can I glance over at the dog?
You see the dog tinkering with this metal that he had pulled off from Nero.
So I just got one thing to say. I've got thumbs.
Sebastian's having great deal difficulty fashioning this armor to be able to fit himself.
Look at Luden.
I said, bring it here, boy.
Take it away, chief.
All right, I'm going to try to help fashion him a nice little set of armor.
Survival check. Oh.
Damn!
There you go, baby.
So at this point, you actually know the exact intricacies of this armor. The points where you can twist and have it curve to the body that you need. For some
he knows
reason,
that armor better than I did.
For some Shit. Reason, you know this armor intimately, way better than Solaire ever did. He just put it on and just took it for granted. But you know,
maybe
this
armor. Maybe I should have become a blacksmith.
I'm also curious as to how well he tied on that headband, because remember Solaire fiddled with that thing for a good half hour.
Well, you also had it over your eye,
Yeah, you did.
Well, I was blind in that eye, I couldn't get an explosion to the face and the rest of my body.
I forgot how long that it took.
So I want to go ahead and make him some armor, but I want to keep some remaining pieces for myself.
You'll have to do an investigation check on Solaire's body to do that.
How's that?
That is pretty good. So Tyler, I'm sending you this on Facebook. You gain all of the abilities of this armor.
Wow. We are creating a monster dog.
And the question of the movement boots.
Yeah.
Is there any way that those can be melted down or anything and fashioned into claws?
Perhaps in Hell or Hellforge, something hot enough to burn the metals of Hell.
If you read the demon armor, you've already gained claws from that.
True. The demon armor gauntlets provided you sharpened claws that increased your unarmed damage and gave you +1 attack to attack rolls and damage rolls, in addition to making your unarmed attacks magical in nature.
You can already do that from Monk, but because Luden had fashioned it so perfectly, you gained the full benefit of the armor instead of just a partial.
Sweet.
Hey, can I...
Which, considering you're a dog, is really good.
Yeah.
Can I fashion a gauntlet from my left hand?
Do a survival check.
Can I do it at advantage because my perfect roll?
Yeah, because you know this armor so fucking well, you get an advantage on that.
Well...
Okay.
This was an advantage.
So you go to craft it, and it actually looks kind of shoddy. you used all your mojo for Sebastian's armor for the day.
He's one of those guys that can only craft for animals.
Does this add a 1d8 to my attacks?
Yeah.
Holy shit.
Yeah. Yep. Nice. You got yourself some serious armor.
And a +1. So it's +1 plus a 1d8.
Yep.
And +1 to my armor class.
Yep.
Hell yeah, dude.
You guys
Big
are
dick
like,
swinging.
You guys are like Native Americans using Solaire's body, every ounce of him for the greater good. You guys want to use his eyeballs and take out his tongue?
quick chop off all his hair.
Do you guys want to loot his body further, like, or?
I know we gotta bury him and pay our respects.
Does Biscuit want to take his eyeball for just casual licking?
No.
Oh, that would be something else.
He only enjoys his own eyeballs.
John, I was about to make you do it. Don't whisper it if you don't want it.
No, because I know that would come with very serious repercussions.
Yes.
All right.
We ready to burn?
While he's burning them, I'm going to bury Gretchen. Do I gain anything with my new gauntlet, or is it just...
I'm gonna need help burning him. I don't have thumbs.
John,
all right.
You get plus... Because it was so shoddily made, you'll get a plus one... No, plus five to maximum health while you're wearing it.
Right.
So you guys have already put them in the holes, I'm assuming. Or no?
Yeah, they're in the ditch. Okay.
So both of them are in the ditch. Sonya was already buried thanks to Solaire.
I'm not done. I haven't buried Gretchen yet. I'm going to check him too.
There we go. Oops.
All right. Can I light this?
I have the Game of Thrones music playing in the background.
Gretchen's not going in the same hole. I was digging a separate hole for him.
Full of Castamere. Yes.
Did you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay.
I just moved him around because Sebastian was digging near his grave first.
Okay. Well, I'm gonna help light the fire for Sebastian. So should I just do a survival check?
How are you lighting the fire? What do you have?
Grab some leaves, kindle some fire. You know, do the whole Boy Scout.
Well, Kindle? Where do you get this Kindle from?
All right. Well, goddamn. Let me look around the ground for some leaves.
You have a sorcerer right next to you.
Granted, that is. Oh, hey.
Yeah, Ulthor at this point catches up. He takes his time, his sweet time.
I was mainly talking about Biscuit, but yeah,
I'm
gonna help too.
Well, not just a sorcerer, but like a freaking dragon.
I know.
I'm not a clever man.
All right,
and I'm a good boy.
I pat Sebastian's head.
I mean, y'all haven't buried him yet.
We're waiting in case you guys want to say some last words.
I haven't been very good at this.
I don't think anybody really is.
You guys see Biscuit just sniffling and tears rolling down his cheeks.
I hold out my arm to bring Biscuit in.
Can I take the dagger back from Solaire?
Easily. Because he can't resist you.
Yep. Forgot I gave it to him so he could kill himself.
They haven't actually lit the bodies on fire or covered them up or anything yet, right?
Nope.
No.
Alright, I'll just walk up to each one and just kind of make sure like their eyes are closed and just kind of let them know that their death won't be for nothing.
At this point, it actually starts storming and it starts raining.
Well, better light this fire before the wood gets too wet.
You might want to step back.
I step behind Ilithor.
Just in case, because sometimes things tend to go a lot stronger than I plan.
You're like when you burn my hands off.
I want to start placing Gretchen into the grave.
Okay.
But also giving him a pat down.
Wow.
Do I notice that?
Do a perception check. So that's your slide. Holy shit.
Okay. Holy shit.
So you feel, Luden, you're feeling up on Gretchen.
All right.
You feel the hairs on the back of your head just like turning up. You look behind you and you see Illithor's eyes meeting yours perfectly. Just staring you down like the scolding mother almost.
All right, I put my hands up and just let Gretchen slowly down into the grave and start shoveling.
Well,
shoveling, we're laying on fire.
No, Gretchen's not being set on fire.
All right, well, I'm burning Solaire's ass.
Well, they were kind of all our party members. So
who's getting burned and who's not?
Solaire's getting burned.
That was the dog's idea. I was just giving Gretchen a proper burial.
I guess I'll cast Firebolt. Firebolt, not ball.
Just making sure.
On Solaire.
Is that a nat 20 for your Firebolt?
Keep in mind where we're at, John. We're in the City of the Dead.
Yeah.
If there's anything that still lingers, burying them is not going to be a good idea.
He may have a point. We don't know much about this area.
Alright, well, let me just fucking pull him out of the hole I just dug. Could have said while I was digging.
Leave him in the hole. We're gonna bury him in the fucking... It's like a pig roast.
I'm just gonna step back and let them do their thing.
Besides, if you knew Gretchen, you would know he'd want to go on fire.
So what are you guys doing?
I'm stepping away.
It looks like me and Biscuit are firebolting the bodies.
Okay, so you guys both firebolt at the same time. Just roll a d20 by itself, each of you, just to make sure that you don't crit fail.
Oh wow. I want to say my d20 plus the 8 was, but yeah, if you just want a regular d20.
Oh, well, that's fine. I didn't see that.
Yeah, so, I just did it because it was an attack roll.
Yeah, that's fine. So at this point, Illithor goes to do it, and it looks normal, but Biscuit does it. And not only does Biscuit launch the firebolt, it actually somehow activates the sky itself, and a lightning bolt shoots down into the grave, launching the entire thing into flames.
Holy crap.
You're going to have to teach me that one.
I'm going to canter next to Biscuit and ask and paw her until she holds my paw. While we watch the flames together.
Aww.
It scratches his ears.
Party tears.
Gonna whimper just a little bit.
I'll be right back.
Okay. Alright, well, I'll let you guys tend to your business. It's been nice meeting you. If you need me, I'll probably be in the hotel or somewhere at an inn. So I'm gonna peace out for the night and make my way to an inn.
Okay. There's inns everywhere. As you head towards the market area, you just look up and you see the whole singed fire area, so you head south. And you actually find some pretty decent inns in this area. You guys have never actually explored this area, so it's actually completely untainted by Illithor.
just Illithor.
Because he's the one who's fireball crazy. I think I'm going to cast fireball for the sixth time this campaign.
I'm going to go ahead and order a beer and kick back.
Okay, so you do that very easily. You walk in, there's no issue. You walk into a bar, a hotel kind of area. It's kind of like a mixed of the, it's like a hybrid. You have both.
Oh shit, where did Franz go?
What the hell did I miss?
I'm still here.
I come back and I hear you're walking into a bar.
I was trying to whisper to you.
The rest of the party sees the fires begin to die down after the rain had done its job. The clouds themselves are still very dark. The rain is getting heavier. And it's beginning to become really cold at this point. And a slight fog is setting in. And it is around 9 o'clock at night, getting really dark.
Does it seem to only be above the City of the Dead, or does it seem like it's stretching all through the city?
As far as you can tell, it's everywhere.
right. Have we covered up the holes?
You haven't told me that.
All right. I just assumed that was what we were doing after we set it on fire. So yeah, we'll, I guess me and Sebastian will start covering up the holes since it looks like Luden left.
Okay, you do that pretty easily. Doesn't take much effort. It took you about half an hour to do so, to make it fully covered and make it look semi-decent, because these were your companions, however much you might have hated them.
should we find somewhere to stay for the night?
That's Biscuit? That's a little talking to Biscuit and Illithor.
Yeah, we should probably sleep.
I don't know what's going on with the weather, but it looks like we might want to get inside.
Oh, how I did the lightning bolt.
God, random person.
He's dancing. Okay, so you guys casually make your way. You walk out of the City of the Dead, and you look north, and you remember the market being completely singed and that entire area being just razed and destroyed. So you see a guard walking around just kind of casually in the rain, and he says, "Halt! What are you doing here?"
We're just looking for somewhere to call it a night.
What the fuck are you giggling about?
I have no idea.
Trying to get some shelter from the rain.
Please go south and go to the Battering Main. That inn will serve you well, and it's one of the nicest ones we have left.
I appreciate it. Do try to stay dry.
You as well. Well met, citizen.
You too, guard.
What is Sebastian giggling for?
How did you find that picture?
What did I miss?
We're all at an inn in case you want to introduce something, or I don't know what you're planning on doing.
Oh my god, that dog. That armor.
What in the world?
He's gonna have a hard time humping other dogs now, though.